All right, Carson Wentz against the 49ers. We talked about him a lot last week. We've talked about him a lot in general. We were all in on Wentz for a while. He's not looked the same. What was your takeaway from Sunday Night Football?
I would not give up on him by any means, but there are the criticisms right now. He struggled with this last year, is a guy that struggles to like throw changeups. Like Carson, not everything can be just a power shot, but he at any given moment can make a play where you just went, oh my God, like that. It's just a play where you shed a defensive lineman, you run away from a defensive lineman, you throw a ball across your body, you hit a guy in stride. Even how beautiful, I thought Collinsworth did a great job on that last play. And maybe it's because he's a wide receiver, of just like one 1,000, two 1,000. When the guy got a release and Carson let it rip, how long the ball was in the air. And just, I mean, that's just the perfect throw to a guy that he clearly is not like, has been throwing to for years. Like that was really high level stuff. That's to me where Jeffrey Lurie, Howie Roseman get on the elevator at Levi's, go downstairs and go, we can at least take a deep breath. You know, the guy that we gave all this money to, that we drafted, that everyone's like, I mean, they're playing. This was so stupid, guy. They're playing the collars on WPIN. I love it, though.
That is classic. That's what John, to set up a narrative.
Well, it's very executives that, you know, from the 90s, that shit worked. It's 2020. Carson Wentz probably drives, I'd guess, a King Ranch Ford. I'll just guess a Chevy or Ford. Souped up, brand new truck. The moment he walks into his car, his phone connects. My mom, for example, is 70. I think she turns 70-something in later this month. She does not know when she gets in her car. Libra. She has a newer car. It goes immediately to Sirius. She wouldn't even know where you would find terrestrial radio. And she's in her 70s, let alone the kids who immediately go to their phone. He does not listen to terrestrial radio. It's not even... Honestly, he might not even understand, like, where do I find it? It's not even in his vernacular. This is just a simple reality of the times we live in, and I get why the executives do the narrative, because it's an easy one. Rip some calls. It's kind of outdated, wouldn't you agree? Just given, like,
so,
it's so easy for him to avoid. Like, so, he's not listening to those radio stations.
100% yes, it's outdated. I do think it serves a purpose, though, on TV, which is here is the conversation happening in Philadelphia. I think the thing that's always really bugged me is when we say players say they don't hear it, but they hear it. Well, yeah, they hear it. They hear it because they get asked. Everyone's saying you need to be replaced. What do you think about that? He's like, I don't really listen to that. Well, that's how he becomes aware of it, right? Is because he's asked about it. But 100%, it's not that hard not to listen to sports talk radio. Trust me.
Yeah,
and I love people who do it. I check in from time to time, but it's the idea that Carson, like, oh, if he says he doesn't listen, he's lying. It's like,
but
he
even like
it.
Okay, well, what about the newspapers? Yeah, he ain't getting the newspaper to his house.
Well, you know, what, usually you have like associates that are on Twitter and tell you what's up if you want to know. But you might be a guy where people know not to tell you.
We used to, when you walked into the NovaCare. And I'd grab one every day. They'd have like the two major papers stacked up.
Really?
And you just grab one.
Even if the cover was like, Doug's got to go, or Andy's time has come.
Yeah, I mean, and most people, you just go in the, you know, the breakfast room, or, you know, it'd just
be
paper
sitting there.
Gone by.
Yeah.
Well, no, it was, you'd have to grab it where the person, when you walk into the main entrance, sits, but she doesn't get there till 8:30. So every coach and player is there between 6 and 7:30 walking in their stack of papers. If you want one, they are there. Now, I don't know if they're still doing that. Probably not. But why would
iPads.
Who knows?
iPads with the athletic scholarships on them.
Because one of the narratives tonight was like, well, I guess it wasn't a quote unquote narrative. It was that Al had asked him clearly, like, what do you think about Doc Rivers? He's like, what? Well, it's like, if he wasn't on Twitter and it was Friday getting ready to travel, he might not have known that Doc Rivers was the coach. It's easy if you're a quarterback, focus on the game plan,
so,
and not on Twitter / talk radio to not know what's going on.
I find it so easy in my life, if there's something I'm focused on, to block everything else out. I just don't get on Twitter. And I could go 2 days unless somebody texts me about Doc, which why would anyone text him about Doc Rivers without knowing about Doc Rivers? So I buy that. To me, here, my thoughts watching him play were a few things. One, I do think they got to be a little careful. Now, who am I to tell Doug Peterson forcing Jalen Hurts on the field in like weird situations? Like the bad snap fumble. Like Carson Wentz should have just been the quarterback in that situation late in the game. But I understand if you want to run the ball, I'm pretty concerned about Carson physically holding up for the rest of his career. And he's already had injuries. But he takes so many big shots. He fights for every yard down the sideline. He doesn't step out. He takes on every defender. He
doesn't slide.
Doesn't slide. Extends every play. So that's the first thing. Like
he's Cam Newton-ish that way. So he is not a slider.
That's a real concern in terms of
his career longevity. What was your tweet? Jalen Hurts should keep his helmet on.
Keep his helmet on the whole game because it's not a joke. Like he just has to be ready to go in with this guy. So that's the first thing. The second thing is he might just be so inconsistent he can't really win successive playoff games and win you Super Bowl, right? Because he's never going to manage a game if your defense is great. He's going to try and make plays. And he might just not be buttoned down enough to consistently win enough games that it takes to win a championship. But from a playmaking standpoint, he is one of the elite players. He is an elite playmaker at the quarterback position in the National Football League. He just is. He beat – now, Mullins helped him, but he beat the 49ers on Sunday.
I think if he was on a team –
with no help.
Miles Sanders, pretty good player.
Okay.
But he had 45 yards.
And you could argue Ertz helps at least get other guys open. And, hey, give Old Dominion credit. The guy made the play.
If I told you right now the Niners for the rest of the year had Carson Wentz as their quarterback, he'd drive Kyle nuts and stuff, you would feel they'd be a 100% playoff team, right?
Yeah.
He has some flaws. Mean,
the question
I mean,
is,
but
would the stuff that he screws up that you think is quote unquote a layup, right? Would he get better at that stuff? Because Doug seems to be, you would know better than me, a pretty good coach of the quarterback, right?
So well, I thought a couple times tonight, I thought Doug had some moments tonight. Like, hey guys, I think Doug kind of gets talked about like the village idiot. Like, remember, he's won some playoff games, beat Belichick. He did a quarterback sneak where the Niners going all out for it. He goes shotgun. And it's like, damn, what do they got? And then boom, right back to the quarterback sneak, and it was kind of genius. It's like that's like a Kyle level play. Like that's, I know fans of crappy teams just be like, you know, when like Gruden, for example. I think sometimes what goes wrong with the Raiders, you go, I watch probably too much Raider football. I don't even know why I do it at this point.
I enjoy it. That's why I watch it.
Yeah, it was like, where's the ingenuity here? Like that's a level play of like we got different pitches in the bag, guys.
Well, the Alec Ingold touchdown against New England, and the other what was the other play that was great against New England?
No, but I'm just saying, like, I understand where fans, the teams that lose all the time, you just look for some creativity. Like, it's just stuff like that. Like, if Carson was on a team with Alshon 100% healthy, Ertz, Goddard, all their offensive linemen 100% healthy, they'd be really good, wouldn't they? Like, and their defense fully healthy. If the Eagles were fully healthy, they'd be really good with Carson Wentz as their quarterback. When I say really good, like, maybe a 10-11 win team.
Yeah. And
you agree with that statement? And he could throw like 40, not maybe not 40, but he'd throw 35 touchdowns.
You're saying they'd win 11 games if he wasn't, even if he wasn't the 2017 version of Carson?
No, I'm saying like what he is now, if you just stacked his team, like with all the guys that he has on his roster that are all in sweats, were just fully healthy, I think they would be potent on offense. I think he's throwing it to guys. Now, I think I would relate him to a basketball player. When you are asked to just carry the load, I think your mindset changes a little bit, especially when you're a younger player. I think like Brady's and Rodgers, and they can just kind of see the bigger picture. I think Carson's still in like this prove it mode. Just think about anyone that's listening. When you're trying to prove it to someone professionally, there is an element of like, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to make sure these guys know it. And as you get older, you realize like, I don't need to prove it this. I can do this. And you just have some levity in your life. You can just kind of take a step back. I don't think Carson can take a step back because he's fighting this kind of elephant and Nick Foles in the room. I don't think he's listening to talk radio, but I think it's pretty clear he's got 7 picks in 4 games. He's like, people are probably saying I suck. My teammates aren't that good, so I got to try to make extraordinary plays. And it's easy to play the hero ball. And when you're playing hero ball with dude from Old Dominion, it's a lot of times it doesn't look good. It did that play, right? I just understand him attempting to just carry the franchise, and it can look really bad. Where I think most Niner fans they're watching go, if you watch a lot of football, his talent is immense.
Yeah. Remember what I said to you on the last pod? If Wentz throws two interceptions, what happens, right? And it was, well, the Eagles lose. Well, he didn't throw two picks. He threw one. And the touchdown play was, I mean, they had the better quarterback on Sunday. Simple as that.
Yeah. He made some plays with his legs, too.
Yeah, he's just wears you out, probably.